Did it say protected anointing? Somebody shout say hallelujah. Did it say what? Protected anointing. No matter how long they continue, we've been there. No, come on now. When God get around it, he will bring the right people in your life. No matter how long that you think you are. Mother been there, daddy been there, done that. Yeah, God has blessed you to put you on your own route. Say never on my own route. You are on your own route. God has recognized you and placed you on your own route, on your own place of blessing. Where people can even recognize you. In your own route. But joy, listen, somebody say praise the Lord. I'm about to finish. Here, joy and his people, they did not stop. They kept on doing what God told us, what David sent them to do. Let's take it to the 16 first. And then what? Cry out, a wise woman. Somebody say a wise woman.
Wise woman.
I hope this ring bells somewhere. Yeah. There are some people who stay sleeping. No matter how much you try to educate them, they stay sleeping. Every man or every woman that showed that white teeth to you don't care a damn for you. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Somebody say, Lord, thank you.
Lord, thank you.
Then what happened in the 16th verse? Then cry out, a wise woman out of the city. Hear, say, I pray you unto whom? Joy. Come near here that I may what? Speak with you. This wise woman in this city, she saw that her city was under trouble. She saw that her city was under siege. And the men in the city were shaking up. Nothing they could do. Because they were afraid of Joab. They were afraid of the king's army, the king military. But this wild woman was strong enough to investigate. Oh, my goodness. Say, neighbor. Investigate. Come on now. Investigate Mr. 900 Shiny Armor. Investigate Ms. Shinene. Come on. Somebody say, neighbor, investigate. Hello, no matter, no, come on, let me put it this way. Because some of you, there are some people that can easily entice by their family name. Hello, there are some folk that can easily be enticed by their family name. They can easily be enticed by their position in the community. They can easily be enticed, my goodness, by their good, so-called good looks. But they can be looking good on the outside, but they are dead on the inside. Full out with drugs. Full out with STD. Full out with sickness and diseases. Come on, somebody say, praise the Lord. Watch out for the good looking one. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Yeah, this wise woman is asking questions. She is investigating. Mr. Mayor, why are you knocking on my door? Sister, why are you knocking on my wall? That's a wise woman. Come on now. I hope I'm not stepping on your toe this morning. Somebody say, praise the Lord. It's all in the Bible. Yeah, and cried a wise woman out of the city. Hear, said I pray you unto joy. Come near here that I may what? Speak with you.
Yes.
Please, do not be enticed by what you hear on your cell phone. The woman said, come, let me look you down. Is that right, sweetheart? Oh, yeah, oh, we're looking down, folks, girl. Say, come on, let me look you down. Let me come on now. Man, that's how I grew up. That's how I grew up. grew up. We don't look at a car by the color. We like to look under the hood to see what size of engine. I do not understand. You got to investigate. Is that right? Somebody said, praise the Lord. He got to, if the woman said, Jehovah, come in here and let me see who, no matter how powerful you are, I want to know who you are. I want to see who you are. Not by texting. Not by what? No Facebook.
No Instagram.
Let me see you for myself. Somebody said, praise the Lord. That's what they call her, the wise woman.
Yes.
I want to call her a wise woman. Joab, let come here, let me see you for myself. The men in the city in front of you, but son, I want to know who you are. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Now, said the woman cried, a wise woman out of the city. Here, said I. Pray you unto Joab. Come near here that I may speak with you. And when he was what? Come near unto her. The woman said, I doubt Joab. It's your name, Joab. Are you the one who's been here for all these years? Hello? Are you the brother that is from our family who's been here for all these years? Man, you're good looking. But what on your hood? Sister, you good looking. But why is it about, how do you describe yourself? How is your brain stand? Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
You just resemble your daddy, but do you have your daddy character? You resemble your mother. You look like your mother's child, but do you have your mother character? Come on now. Do you have your father taste? Somebody said, praise the Lord. This thing is not by name. Not, no, come on, don't go for the name. Joab come near. The 7th verse said, and when he was come near unto her, the woman said, I doubt Joab, and he answered, I am he. Then she said unto him, hear the word of thy handmaid. And he answered, I do hear. Say, hear me too. I've been hearing you all these years. Now you listen to me, brother. You listen to me, sister. I've been hearing your messages to me on cell phone. Your messages to me on Instagram. Your messages to me by email. Now, you listen to me too.
Yeah, that's right.
That's a wise one. That's right. That's a wise man.
So true.
Investigates.
Yeah.
Before I even visit your house, let me know some quality about you. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Somebody say, glory to God.
Glory.
Yeah, this one was so wise. She was so wise because she did not want to lose what God had blessed her with. She did not want to lose her house. She did not want to lose her city. She did not want to lose her children because of a knucklehead that had it among her house. In her house. I hope somebody can listen to something from their message this morning. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Somebody said, glory to God. The 18th verse said, then she speaks saying. Now listen, she giving a parable. Listen, how intelligent, giving a parable to Joab. Then she speaks saying, they were once to speak. They speak to us once in the old days. Somebody said, old time.
Old time.
In the old days, they said there was a proverb in the old time saying, they shall surely ask counsel at Abel. Now you're going to hear the next verse, what she said to Joab. This is a place they come from what? To get counsel from us. We may look scared, but we are wise. That's what she was saying. We may look scared. We may not have the sophistication you have. We may not have the family name you have. We may not have the connection you have with the king. But here, wise people live here. Say, neighbor, wise people live here. Say, neighbor, wise people work with me. Say, neighbor, I am wiser. I am much better. Hallelujah, I am much stronger. I'm much better, I'm much wiser, and I'm much stronger. Wise people live here. You just don't walk in my house and think you can take over.
I know that's right. I know that's right.
You, come on now. You can't just walk in my place of business that God blessed me with. And you think because your good look, you think your good look will let you in? Good Lord, don't mean nothing to me. Your family need don't mean nothing to me. Your connection with somebody or government official don't mean what? Nothing to me. Do you have the wisdom God has blessed me with? Do you have the understanding God has blessed me with? Do you have the anointing God has blessed me with? Do you have the connection God has blessed me with heaven? These are the kind of people that I'm looking for. Someone that has connection with heaven. Someone that has a godly wisdom. Someone that has a godly ideas. Someone that keeping his or her body holy. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Woo. Say, Joe and I are in front of you. What is your problem? Hello, I may not look sophisticated to you, but I guess wisdom of God in me. I have the Spirit of God in me. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I'm not hungry for what you have.
That's right.
Come on now. Come on. I'm not hungry for what you have. I'm content with what God has blessed me with. And I protect what God blessed me with. Somebody shall say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Well, I'm not running competition with you.
That's right. Say that.
George. He needs to come here and ask wisdom of this city. When God bless you and plant you in your own place, you can use wisdom to protect what God bless you with. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Then speak saying, the 19th verse. Yeah, the 19th verse. What's the? I am one of them. Look at what the woman is saying. I am one of them that are what? Peaceable and faithful in his will. Thou seekest to destroy a city and a mother in his will. Will thou what? Swallow up the inheritance of the law? My goodness. This is the woman that knew herself. Say, neighbor, you got to know yourself. This is the woman that knew herself. She knew her position.
Yes.
So neighbor, you gotta know yourself.
Then
nothing can shake you.
Yes.
Nothing can entice you. Yes. Come on, you can't get wrong when they tell you to wrong.
Yes.
You can't get move when they tell you to move. So neighbor, you just have to know yourself.
Yes, thank you,
Jesus. Wise woman. A wise woman. Somebody say a wise woman.
A
wise woman cannot be moved easily. I'm going to repeat that verse to you once again. Yes, I am one of them that are what?
Peaceable.
Ah! Don't let no one disturb your peace. Hello? The Bible said be peace with all men, if possible. Don't let no one disturb your peace. You understand? Because God placed you in your place. He has taught you how to get peace.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Your peace of mind has not been disturbed for years.
Right.
Your body in peace.
Free.
Your head in peace.
Yes.
Your spirit in peace.
Yes.
You feel so comfortable now.
Yes.
You can walk in mind in a comfortable dress, a comfortable shoe.
Yes.
Your environment is comfortable. Why should you allow the devil to mess it up?
Yes.
I am peaceable.
Yes, Lord.
This woman in her said,
yes,
she will enjoy her peace.
Yes.
Somebody said, praise the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody said, glory to God.
Glory to God.
Oh, hallelujah. I am one of them that are peaceable. And what? And faithful in Israel. I'm faithful to my assignment. I'm faithful to my assignment. I'm faithful to my God. I'm faithful to my Lord Jesus Christ. I'm faithful working with his angels. But that will not stop the devil from battering your war. Because he will continue to come. But at least will you continue to stand. To stand on your position. To stand on your ground of holiness. Will you continue to stand on your ground of faithfulness? Because the devil will not stop now. They will come in all kinds of clothing. They will come in all kinds of ways. All kinds of directions. Hello? They come as undercover demons. Because you don't understand. You get rid of one today, the demon possesses another body to come after you. It's just a trumper. Have you ever seen an undercover boss?
Yes.
Oh, come on now. They come as undercover. Oh my goodness. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Oh, I like him because she is hanging over my mother friend. Oh, I like him because his brother is in my church. Or his sister is in my church. Oh, somebody has said, praise the Lord. Somebody has said, glory to God. Some kind of way the devil will try to entice you. You don't know if there's an undercover demon coming to you. Watch that devil in the blue dress. Somebody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
What that is the shining knight on the arms. On the shining, shining arms. Yeah, look at what the woman is saying here to Joel. I'm one of them that are peaceable and faithful in Israel. And thou seek to destroy a city and what? And another what? And a mother in Israel. With what? When thou swallow up the inheritance. This woman knew herself. She said, man, I'm a mother in Israel. A mother means someone that has been there, done that. Come on, and you can't deceive the animal, no matter what you have, no matter who you are. No, come on, no matter what your connection may be, I'm still a mother. I've been there. I've seen it all. You can't intimidate me easily. And it freaked this man up. And if you read the whole chapter, you will get to know that Joel never listened to women. That's true. You will know that Joel never compromised with any military people. This is a man that caused David to weep because he killed someone that David did not honor him to kill. This, he was so militant that he would walk to you. You read the same chapter, he would just walk to you. As long as you were against the king, he kills you. Now here he's talking to a woman for the first time in the whole scripture. Somebody said, praise the Lord.
And
it was not just an ordinary woman, but a wise woman. Somebody said, a wise woman.
A wise woman.
Listen to a wise woman for the first time. Now see what Joab said to her. And the 20th verse says, and Joab answered and said, Far be it from me that I will what? Swallow up or destroy. Then he began to tell the woman the problems that he ordered his man to break down the walls. He said, the matter is not so, but a man of Mount Ephraim Sheba, the son of Beri, by name, had lifted up his hands against the king, even against David. Deliver him only. Get rid of that man. Get rid of that sin in your midst. Get rid of that knucklehead. Get rid of that crackhead. And get back in fellowshipping with God. Yeah, come on now. Get rid of that crackhead. And get back in fellowshipping with God. Get rid of that knucklehead. That lazy breath. Get rid of that man or woman that don't know they own their own needs. And get back into fellowshipping with God. Say, get rid of that one man. Because if you don't get rid of him, he will bring down all these things you've been working for. He will bring down your business. He will destroy your name. How many, how many brother or how many sister that have been brought down by drug addicts, by drug addicted brothers or sister, because you hang out with them, the next day they're giving you pills. They're giving you alcohol. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Because your thinking is not their thinking. They have their own agenda. That's what they want to come around you. The devil send them to you to destroy you. Remember, the devil is going around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he will destroy. Somebody said, praise the Lord. Look at the wise woman. Now hear what Joel is telling her. Somebody said, thank you, Jesus. And Joel answered and said, Far be it from me that I should swallow up or destroy. The matter is not so, but a man. Can I say something to you? All men, not men. There are some that can hide behind closed doors and wear women dress. All women dresses. I don't want to go there. Maybe if you don't know, I don't want to go there. So, come on, I say, praise the Lord. The matter is not so, but a man of my Ephraim, Sheba, the son of Beri, by name, had lifted up his hand against the king, even David. Deliver him only, and I will what? Depart from the city. And what did the woman say? And the woman said unto Joab, behold, his hair what? His hair shall be thrown to thee over the wall. His head shall be what? Thrown. Come on now. Say, neighbor, throw him over the wall. Come on, shake him with somebody. Say, neighbor, throw him over the wall. Come on, shake him with people. Say, neighbor, can you throw him over the wall? You don't get it. Say, neighbor, when you trap, throw her over the wall. That's right. You don't get it. Say, neighbor, throw him or her over the wall. They are not there to meet you any good. They are only there to destroy what God is blessing you with. They are there to destroy your family. They are there to destroy your peace. They are there to destroy your happiness. They are there to destroy everything God is blessing you with in your life. So never throw them over the wall. Somebody say hallelujah. And this is a wise woman. Yeah, can I repeat to you what a woman said again? Can I repeat to you what she said? Yeah. See, I'm not gonna allow the knucklehead to destroy my family, to destroy my people. Yes. Hallelujah. Yeah. Somebody say hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't let that knucklehead destroy your good home and your peace in your home, brother or sister. Hello. If your white hair don't look good to you, give her some money. Let she go do your hair for us.
Right there.
Hello. If you don't like the dress you're wearing, head for that coach, let you go shop. Get off the shoes. Somebody say, praise the Lord. For some form of the other, encourage her. Amen. She would dress for you. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Encourage him and he would dress for you. Hallelujah. If you be a Tarzan, what's she going to be?
A genie.
Somebody said, praise the Lord. But you see, one of the things that I want you to understand, this woman knew where her blessing was coming from, and she was protecting her place of blessing. Say, neighbor, protect your place of blessing. Protect your place of peace. Protect your place of joy. Protect the place of your family. Protect your family. Somebody say, glory to God. Somebody say, a wise woman. Yes. A wise woman. Hear what she said to Joy. Joy, you want them to go ahead, you can have him. And Joy answered and said, no, the 21st verse. The portion of what the woman said. The woman said unto Joy, behold, his head shall be what? Thrown. Over where? The wall. But she couldn't do it alone. She never can do it alone. Oh my God. No man is an island by himself. Now let her look at what she did. Because she couldn't do it by herself. The Bible says the 22nd verse says, then the woman did what? She went unto what? All the people in her wisdom. She went seeking for counsel. Say, neighbor, you are not alone in the church. Say, neighbor, you are not alone in the church. You can talk with a brother in the church. You can talk with a pastor in the church. You can talk to a sister in the church. She can give you some good wisdom. Amen. How to get rid of that knucklehead. Well. Oh my, you're going to have an earful now. How you could get rid of that knucklehead? How to get rid of that laser man? How to get rid of that gold deacon? Come on now, somebody say, praise the Lord. How to get rid of the agents of the devil. So she went to all the men, all the people in the town, in her wisdom. Remember, she said, my town is a place that people get cancer from. You should build, listen, sister of God, you should build your family. You should build your life. You should build your house in a way that somebody will see some good in you, that they can come to you for advice. They can come to you for wisdom. Is that right? They can come to you for understanding. Yes. This woman said, the people get cancer from us in this town. Yes. And the Bible said, she went. And the woman went unto all the people in her wisdom. And did what did they do? They cut over the head of Sheba, the son of Beri, and what happened? And cast it out to Joab. And what did he do? He blew the trumpet and what? And from the city what? Every man to his tent, and Joab returned to Jerusalem. How will you save your city, neighbor? How will you save your city? Because every one of us that God has given us our portion. The portion of blessing. How can you say you follow the blessing plan? You follow the advice of your loved ones around you that are building you up, holding you up. Somebody say hallelujah. Somebody say glory to God. Because when the outsiders are coming, the outsider that you are inviting in your place of business, he or she may come as a spy. Hello? He or she may come as a spy. The sister or brother that you may be hanging out with, they may look sweet to you, but you don't know what is that secret agenda. Somebody may have sent them in your life to get rid of you. Because you are doing good. Your business is doing good. The fee that you are taking away, their customers. Oh, who the Lord talking to? Yeah. There are competition out there. There are some that started the same business God bless you with that is prospering. Some of them started it, didn't go nowhere. And the jealousy is always be there. They will cut their eyes at you. Stuck behind you. Gossip about you. And some of them, you don't know them from nowhere. Is that right? Some of them, you don't know them from nowhere. You never met them. But because they are hearing your fame, God is promoting you. Little by little, they are hearing your fame. They are seeing your advertisement. They are seeing the work that you can do. They are seeing, my goodness, the products of your works. And they will do everything and all things to bring you down. So how can you save your city? How can you protect your city? You keep on doing what God told you to do to cause him to continue to bless you, to cause him to continue to heal you, to cause him to continue to deliver you. You stay on your ground. You stay with a blessing plan. Say, neighbor, stay with a blessing plan. You don't turn to the left or to the right. Is that right? Don't turn to the left or to the right. You get loved ones around you that embrace you, that want the best for you. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The scripture says, in all of your ways acknowledge him. God sent his people around you. That when you tell them your problem, they start to pray for you. Is that right? You don't expect God to come here in person. This place is too big for him. To come here in person. He went through people to get to you. He went through people to counsel you. He went through people to help you. He went through people to give you understanding. He went through people to give you wisdom. He went through people to keep you above. He went through people to protect you. Somebody say hallelujah. He went through people to hold you up. God went through people to hold you up.
Thank you, Jesus.
But you gotta know the same thing, you gotta know the difference. Who is for you and who is against you? You gotta know the difference. You gotta know the difference. Who is for you? Or who is against you? You got to know the difference. You don't just answer to any job. You don't know them from nowhere. Although you've been seeing them in the city for a long time. Seeing me in the city every day doesn't mean that you know me.
I know that's right.
Can I repeat that once again? Yeah. Seeing somebody in the city, seeing every day in the city. Sometimes maybe it's just a short color key walking in the street and you don't know. Or firecrackers walking in the street, you don't know. So you invite them in your house or you invite them in your bed. Sometimes someone that have, my goodness, a flitting walk on the STD. Oh, come on, somebody say, praise the Lord. What kinds of sickness in their body? Demon possessed. What do darkness have to do with light? What do righteousness have to do with unrighteousness? Bird with the same color flocks together. We are having a confused spirit now in this country. Confused spirit in this country where mother are given the right to their 10 years old or 5 years old to become gay and lesbian. It's sad. It's sad when a mother can say, oh, he just 10 years old, he has the right to be what he wants to be a gay or to be a transvestite because he's a girl and he wants to be a boy. They want to allow him, although she has not yet had the operation. She's still a girl, no matter how she look. She may look like a boy, but as long as she get her stuff, she's still a girl. Then you want her to use the men's bathroom because she look a boy. There's a kind of confused spirit in this country now that we are godly people. We gotta wise up and set the example and be the example to our children, be the example to our little ones that are growing up, be the example for all of somebody say hallelujah. But we don't allow for the government to take all of your rights away as a man of God or as a woman of God. Is that right? The Bible says, give to Caesar what is Caesar and what? And give to God what is God. What belongs to God should live godly. Those that belong to God should live righteously. Somebody say hallelujah. Those that belong to God should live righteously. Those that belong to God to protect your body. Don't you know that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? Is that what the Bible says? Give that holy body to anything that knuckleheads. Amen. I will trust in the Lord.